Well, hello everyone. You hear show you right here is the taxes design that I have put together right here, talk about for the brand new gray book as well as for digital design. And if we were talking about for brand new, and when we say brand new, does that basically mean brand new, or why can't we just say new or anything like that? Now, I say the brand new, I guess that basically means factory made. But you see right here is for jobs. You're talking about jobs. And those students who go to school that, if we've done the calculations, about maybe 45% or maybe 70 or so percent that they wind up getting jobs right away. But think about it as to where that, if we're talking about the taxes design, as to where that, I'm sure most of us would maybe think twice about that, as to where that, or maybe think as to where that, after you graduate, the taxes, the objectives about taking care of our taxes, and we can maybe think about as to where that, really, that if it's a job for any student or for anybody, that if it's going to be our job just to be able to take care of our taxes and claim to follow our own taxes, that if anything, that they only comes like maybe three times a year. So if we were to think about this, and we think about if we get a tax return check, for about every 3 years for a certain amount, as if you're filing for for married or if you're filing for single, but you see right here is I would put together right here this print right here a brand new digital design gradebook, and this right here is in 3D. So if we can see this right here, that this right here will be like a like the 3D type look right here, and I know I'm pretty impressed about how this printed off too, because you can actually see the actual wording right here. But that if we've seen this from the previous videos I posted up, but talk about the difference between graphic design and digital design, basically like the source of language. And so it's like about digital design is that you are basically working with a number of documents and then publishing them online, compared to graphic design that you would have a lot of the writing skills and as well as other sources of skills that that you would be trained with for what you learn from whenever you for the source of enrollment, scholarships and grants and stuff like that whenever you were in school. But but I know with me though that every once in a while I have these thoughts about as to where that, if I'm going to be in a room, in a big room, I would probably say that, I usually call it like the size of a gymnasium, but I'm going to be in a big room kind of like this. I would say about, maybe about 100 feet at, length and width, I keep thinking too, maybe about the size of a gymnasium. I'm like, be in a big room, and the way I describe this big room is to where that I would be sitting at a desk right here. If I were to be sitting at a desk right here, and let's just say that this room right here that I would have all to myself, it's like you would have this big, you'd be in a big room right here by yourself. What is the reason to why I just think about this? And mainly because as to where that, really, how many people are going to really understand about, my career so far as designing stuff? And if anybody warns us that, if they come to that point to where that, after you graduate and if you really want to work hard to succeed in what you're working for, then you may think as to where that, that you're told almost all the time that people don't understand that this degree that you talk to people and they may know quite a bit about medical stuff or maybe about anything that is related to maybe automobiles or something like that. Auto mechanic or maybe electricians or a maintenance appliances, a technical appliance work or something like that, maybe crane operation or anything like that, carpentry work. But not too many of them are going to know too much about this digital stuff that I'm working on. So it seems like to where that whenever if people really need your assistance, and maybe they'll go into this room, that more likely that you'll be hanging out to nearly 80% of the time. So the way I drew this right here is if I were to be sitting at a desk right here, and let's just say that, it's going to maybe take, get a student loan, and with the student loan, that just think about it to where that, that yeah, if anybody were to, because like students like me though, the students like me, that I prepare myself a year ahead of time to make payments on a student loan, but then of course, it's like you say, if anybody has heard of disability discharge, that you would have it work it out to where that you will be discharged, you know, due to my disability. So it's like that whenever I think about this, that knowing about for what I got to do with my taxes as well. So whenever I've done the calculations right here, if anybody say that this is where here will be an example of the source of income. The source of income and then the 50% and then as well as the Pell Grants for $7,477.80, and you have right here for graphic design for 1,000 hours and as well as for digital design. 1,000, you say 1,000 hours or so, but if we've done the math about how much time is that equal to 1,000 hours. And I would say that about 48 hours or so, which is 2 days. So I would probably say that, I would say that that's about maybe equal to a week. I'm like, if we've done the calculations, 1,000 hours, and just think about, how much is 1,000 hours equal to? And to me, maybe up to 3 weeks. Yeah, I do calculations up to 3 weeks. So let's just say that when spending so much time studying, but the way I drew this sketch right here, I use a line paper right here, so I can show this example right here, this print right here, and they have right here is these classmates, about how many classmates are going to wind up getting a job, and they say they have right here is for job right there, but I was also thinking about, if anybody warns us to her, what's this all about, but this actually, these are stars right here, if we can see that right there. So it seems like to where that if anybody has come to that point to where that they get frustrated about trying to find work at some point, and you feel like, whenever we're angry a lot of times, that you may think that way to where that whenever you're angry enough that you want to go and just go into a room where there's nobody there to bother you and just study. It's like a study hall class, and if anybody remembers study hall, if everybody here remembers study hall, if they had it whenever they were in high school, that a study, like a room to where you can go into and you can just mainly concentrate on your work. You don't want to be bothered by anybody. You just want to be left alone, just be doing your work. And so it seems like to where that, the type of study hall to where you have a lot of the room to yourself and you're working on stuff. But still, in this room that I went and drew an example right here is mainly talking about the type of study hall to where I learn more my own way. I don't have to really go by necessarily about the requirements, but if anything, that just to kind of learn it at my own pace. And that means is to where that I'm not really used to, very many people being there. But still, that the way I drew this right here is to where that this was supposed to be one of my classmates, example of this person right here. And if anybody asks is to where that, that's what you call, I keep calling it like, say, this person, I guess you say, not really like a, I call it kind of like an imaginary friend, but it's supposed to be somebody that, that if you want to go ahead and imagine about what this person who meets you one of these days, you meet your career, who finds you and they look at your work, but then they just haven't met the person who did the work. But really, those seem like two different things. I don't know why, maybe because that they've seen your work a number of times, but then they just have not met you in person. So it seems like that there's a difference between seeing your work and then meeting the artist in person, and meeting anybody in person, really, because it's like, say, whenever you meet somebody in person, it seems like that you just have a number of thoughts and questions to ask about that. And so if anybody will warn to our whole purpose about the brand new at that, the type of definition I want to describe is mainly about brand new is to where that's something that's just being released and that's just being announced as well that this is a new update. That this is something that I don't think that anybody of us is aware of. And I have right here is my name right here, like a little 3D mark right there. But talk about if anybody were wanting to wonder, we pay taxes though, and especially if we're going to be going to school, that think about it, is to where that that a lot of these classes though that sometimes that if I'm gonna be maybe in this room maybe taking online classes, that if anybody were say that if you're gonna be in school. Just like, besides kindergarten, that whenever you go into the classroom, that, you make friends and you talk to other classmates and then you do stuff with the, do activities with them and learn different sorts of stuff. But let's just say that, at this situation right here, were to maybe come to where maybe if I failed the class, once or twice and I had to take it again, or that, something that became too hard or anything like that, if I was in a study hall class like this right here, and let's just say that if I spent so much time in this class because getting a job was so difficult, maybe because of things, either things change or maybe because, a few things that got postponed or delayed. So this sketch right here that I drew the scene right here is about this girl that, had either found my work or that they knew me since class. And so she's going to ask us toward it, why are you in this classroom alone, Matthew? Just knowing that toward it, for those who understand about what I'm trying to do so far as my major goes, because it seems like not too many people know what digital design means. And so far, graphic design, they know what that means. Web development, and as well as maybe material character design, they know a little bit about, they know about what that is. But there's something about digital design to where it seems like to where it goes in a file and it stays in there for a couple of hours. And it seems like that's exactly about what my situation is, to where whenever we get bills, they go in the file where they go, and then you get back to them later. It seems like to where, you don't need to be treated like a file cabinet, to where that, this file cabinet, that, you just, you go somewhere and a stack of papers and just hang out there for a while until somebody needs you later on. So it seems like to where that, the way I drew this right here is to where that you have right here is this lady right here, and or it could be a guy or anybody else, but let's just say that I have these thoughts sometimes about is to where that with somebody that finds me and they're like wearing to where that with that this purpose about to where why is it that you're in this room alone, and how long have you been in this room? And it's like I say, I'm going to probably be in here for a couple of weeks so I can get caught up on my work, or so that way I can go ahead and pass the class so I can go ahead and be hired on to a job, because it seems like nowadays in a lot of jobs, and then the miss is going to say, wait just a minute, I say that, maybe if a yeah, I have a team of about maybe 3 or 4 people that would be able to help you out. And sometimes you feel like telling some of these people if you really want me bad enough, then maybe that you'll go ahead and I say I also was, if anybody were to say that, really, that it really don't make no sense, really, does it? Is to where that whenever you graduate, you got bills to pay, right? But let's just say something changes to where maybe if you were discharged, or maybe that that you qualify maybe for student loan forgiveness or something like that. And then, trying to find a job, but let's just say with this job that there's only full-time jobs available. There's not too many part-time jobs available. So it's like I say this to where that for anything about what you call the rules and requirements. And it seems like that just does not make no sense, because over the fact about that with for what you're working on, and then after you graduate, that you prepare to make student loan repayments. But you have right here is this this chart right here, this multiplication table right here. But talking about for what will be paid for by the state, and as well as for what is paid for from the taxes. And the way I think about this is to where that if it gets frustrating enough to where you feel like telling people is to where that, you know, you're going to go ahead and, you know, yeah, that, you know, whenever you're mad enough, you're going to maybe say something like, you know, you're going to, you know, I don't know if I really want to draw a door here, but I'll go ahead and draw something like a door right here. But, you know, yeah, I have these thoughts as to where that, then you're going to have to pry your way through the door and reach for the stars. And what does that mean? Well, if anybody says this to her, if anything about what you're talking about, that, you know, yeah, that, you know, people will say that used to like, well, you know, we weren't where that was it that you've been hanging out in that room for such a long time. And to think about is to where, how come you're not returning our emails and how come you're not returning our phone calls and et cetera, et cetera. And I say that, you know, yeah, well, if you weren't so picky about what needs to go on my resume, then maybe I would say is to where that, oh, okay, well, if you need my assistance or if you just want to have a better understanding about this or that, about, you know, about 50% off, it's like you file your taxes online or so, but still, that that's what I was thinking too, is to where that it goes by the question is to where that, that why is it that you're like warned to where that whenever you graduate, you're supposed to get a job. But let's just say if you're told a little bit different, if you got to continue your education, but then you know, this person that sees you, that meets you, is going to probably say that, you know, yeah, well, guess what? I'm like that, let's just say if you were, you know, if you were connected to a team about, you know, four other people, you think the chances of you getting a job. And so a lot of us would maybe say that the getting hired onto a job is very frustrating, because why is it so frustrating? Maybe because about the, you know, the, you know, one student, yeah, let's just say if they've only completed maybe, you know, 1 year or up to 3 or 4 years, and I think, you know, some jobs may require up to 4 years of completed college courses just to be able to get a job. And that seems like an awful, you know, quite a bit, you know, a long time. And I know, like anybody probably say, if you're going to be filing your taxes, that let's just say if it's up to 4 years, it's 4 years that they want you to complete a number of courses. And with the 4 years, like I say, if that goes on a grade book to where that, for how you file your taxes. But let's just say that if following our taxes was considered a job, if it was considered what you call this you know, taxes design activity that I'm talking about, that you're like thinking about is to where, okay, tax design, I mean, I don't get it at all. What do you mean by that, Matthew? What I mean is to where that you develop ideas about where you're going next. You know, not really about, you know, we're talking about maybe 2 years ago, yeah, but where you're going next. That's what I mean by tax design. That by next year, you know, last year you probably filed your taxes maybe using an account, but let's just say this next year that you could be filing your taxes just by using a mobile, you know, app, you know, just by using the mobile app. That all you had to do was just, you know, like if anybody say that, that, you know, nowadays with these mobile apps that you would have it to where that, that just a few clicks just to update. And I don't know if they have anything that works like a multiplication table to whenever you sign on using a mobile device, that all you got to do is just select the amounts that you made it through this prior year and then, you know, prior amount, you know, for whichever columns that need to be completed. And then from there, and then that should only take about maybe 15 minutes at the most just to be able to complete that. But and then like knowing about for anything about what needs to be done, you know, so far as your taxes goes. But if anybody warns us to where that, that, you know, you've had these thoughts about us to where that, yeah, well, you're going to have to pry your way through that door and reach for the stars if you really want me that bad. So if anybody were to say that whenever you get mad that you may think of all kinds of things, you know, so I say, yeah, the door, you know, like, yeah, well, the door is locked. So, you know, here's the thing, the door is locked. And that means is I don't want to be bothered. I don't want to be disturbed. So, like I said, if you let me, you know, let me study so that way I can go ahead and complete these courses and earn my degree just to be able to get the job. And you know, say that, yeah, well, you deny my application last time and you deny me or you keep denying my resume. So if anybody say that, What does it usually mean whenever people come back to you, whenever people ask you again? If it's been about maybe 90 days since your last job interview, and then they come back to you and they're like, notify you by email, and they're like, hey, what's been going on with your case? Well, you keep denying my case. I applied one time, and I tell you one thing, after the second time and after the third time, I got tired of applying, so I just decided to work on some more of these courses that need to be completed in order to be able to earn my certificate, just to be able to earn my degree. And so we may have our long stories, and of course we may also have our reasons to why we do stuff, but talk about for tax design though, that you have right here is classmate of mine, it may take up to maybe 5 years for the federal or for the state to make their decisions about what's paid for and who needs to sign and date what or something like that, what courses that need to be completed in your type of training that we need it just to be able to be hired to a job. But if anybody will warrant to it, that there's something about J-O-B, that if it's supposed to be an abbreviation for something, such as what kind of, journey of, because, journey of because, that your job, there's something about that three-letter word to where if anybody will warrant to where about jobs. Are you talking about the kind of skill that includes a paycheck, or are you talking about join the club? Because to me, it seems like a lot of these, the source of, if it's computer skills, or maybe if you're just, how many of us will maybe think that you would want to go to school just to learn how to make up candy bars, just how to make cookies and candy bars, working for a chocolate factory, candy factory? How many of us would go to college for that? Just to learn how, cooking, I guess you say cooking schools, and I guess that they offer cooking schools. But still, how many of us are going to go to school and get a good, for scholarships and grants? How many of us are just going to join just to join the club? How many of us are going to enroll just to join the club? There may be only about maybe 25% compared to a few of us that, that we expect jobs, and let's just say that with this requirement just to be able to get the job, that one of those requirements will be, say, for tax design, or the other one, it could be sort of good communication. Please communicate with a few other people, a few other professionals. And I just really think that's something that maybe I have been doing, and I have seen some progress, maybe not a whole lot. But if anybody say that, if you don't have the professional skills, and you can always talk to the people who do have the professional skills, and I'm sure that one of these days, they'll say that, we would like to make you an offer one of these days. But how many of us, how many of us have tried that? We're just thinking as to where that, in order to be able to get a good paying job, after you earned your degree, and just thinking about it as to where trying to fight, for the case about trying to get this job, searching, if it's anything about job shadowing, how are you going to get the case to close? If it's been about already a year since you graduated. But with me, though, if anybody say, if you don't have a whole lot of student loan repayments, and as well as if you don't really have, for how much pressure that you really need so far as looking for work. But still, before I graduated, of course, that I was told this is to where that, you'll be able to save so much if you use the online services, of course. So if anybody were to say that right after you graduate, then it comes in hand where you will go ahead and start managing your data, your case online, and making payments online. But still, either way, it seems like to where that if anybody were to say that this scene right here that I drew right here is talking about mainly about making each other feel important, and this room, of course, what I think about a lot of times whenever I think about this is to where that I'm gonna be in this room, for a certain amount of time until that somebody else discovers, finds me, and they're like worried toward it. They have all kinds of questions, and one of those questions that they start ran off a question, and I say that, is that supposed to be a question or is that supposed to be a statement? Why does it make no sense? I know you can't get a job, and what does it matter if it's part time or full time? We're wondering about your skill. You said on your application that you had so much experience, and as well as you mentioned on your application about skills with computers and Microsoft Word. What's going on with that? And do you have a license? So far as your certificate, and license and certifications, and so far as knowing about your skill about how to use Photoshop, Extreme S or something like that, Extreme S, or if it's like anything that is related to Explosion or something like that. It's like you say professional photography. What's going on with that? You want to repeat those? So if anybody were to say that, you start running off questions and it's like, you want to go and repeat those? I'm trying to understand what you're trying to ask me. But anyway, here right here, these amounts right here for 7th day. If anybody were to say that, the way you wrote those down, it's like you want to, that's about how much money you're making compared to the Pell Grants. And, do you expect the income to be more, or do you expect the Pell Grants to be more? And sometimes it seems like the Pell Grants are less, but if we've done the math, then why is it to where that that we see the Pell Grants, the Pell Grants that compared to how much the student loan was compared to the Pell Grants, I guess we know that sometimes the Pell Grants could be a lot less than compared to how much that was borrowed and how much has got to be paid back. But I really just think that that's just how whenever we file our taxes, and then that's just how the state works too, to where that from where the money's coming from, just to be able to pay for the schooling. That really any other way of how to explain it other than that to where that I guess that for what is reported. From the financial aid, from the federal financial aid, and then for the courses that were completed. So let's just say that by each year that whenever we update update the information online to our online accounts, and I guess they'll decide that to where that for the amount of money that is left, because it seems like it happens all the time to where that we may borrow more than what we need, and then comes to that situation too to where. If you don't spend all of it and then it's refunded. But other than that, talk about the difference between graphic design and digital design as well for 1,000 hours. And you have right here for text design. But other than that, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great day.